Purpose of the performing dead path.
First, we will define what is dead path, and then we will tell the purpose, equipment, and considerations. After that, we will perform step by step. Okay, performing dead path definition.
Yeah.
Okay. Performing dead path is a bath given to a client who is in the bed, or the patient is unable to take a bath by himself or herself. So, purpose of bed bath. First, why we need to give bed bath for our patient? To prevent bacteria spreading on the skin, to clean the client's body, to stimulate the circulation, blood circulation, to improve general muscular tone and joint, to make client comfort and help to induce sleep, to observe skin condition and objective symptoms. So, general considerations, as you can read po, observe standing precautions, observe standard precautions, including wearing clean gloves, other personal protective equipment, if necessary, depending on the patient's condition. Check the floor for spills and make sure equipment is working properly. Assess and control the bath water temperature, especially for patients with reduced sensation. Avoid hot or excessively cold water and use a mild cleansing agent that minimizes irritation. Do not soak the feet of a patient with diabetes or peripheral vascular disease. Follow the package instruction when warming a disposable bath in a bath product. To avoid injuring the eyes, ask the patient if he or she is wearing contact lenses. During the bath, assess for signs of warmth, redness, swelling, tenderness, and pain in the lower extremities, because these might be easily signs of deep vein thrombosis. Avoid using force and friction when bathing a patient. Do not massage reddened areas, especially over bony prominences. Massage of the legs is also contraindicated because a blood clot may be present and could become dislodged. Do not use massage for pressure ulcer prevention. If one of the patient's extremities is injured or immobilized, dress the affected side first. Okay. We will tell what are the equipments needed for the bed pad. So we have a basin,
two basins. One with dog soap and one with soap.
Okay. And then two buckets for clean hot water and for the waste.
Yeah, assume that she's a two bucket.
And then one jug of water.
Yes.
Then soap with soap dish. And then sponge cloth or these are wash. The wash cloth. For wash with soap and for the rinse. Face towel. One face towel and then bath towel, two bath towels, or if necessary you can add. And then loose space, 2 to 3, and then trolley, and then thermometer, old newspaper, paper bag for clean clothes or for waste.
Para sa new old newspaper.
Oh, what's it? Para sa new sir. Placement para sa pasa.
Siguro para pamamahala sa mga patient na mga
hindi pagdito sir ay
maset bakit kapag para old newspaper hindi sir para sa dirty
hindi ko din alam. Let's see kung ano baka kana dito lang siya.
So we will go for the steps procedure. Step one. Review chart for any limitation in physical activity. We need to
CNA must and should do for awareness and knowledge for any limitation. Example, if there is a doctor's requirement or a special requirement for the patient, if he or she had an injury, so there is a limitation for doing the performing of bed.
Bring necessary equipment to the bedside stand or over bedside table.
Assemble your equipment and ensure everything is in hand to minimize the amount of time the patient is exposed. Ensure the bed is at the right correct working height.
What is a correct working height na?
Our waist level.
So in this case, are you gonna raise the bed or lower the bed?
Raise the bed,
right? But after you do the bed bath, what will you do?
Lower.
Why? Bakit kailangan lower always?
The patient may be falling.
Huh? The patient may fall, or there's an increased risk of falling. So always talaga dapat naka
low
ang bed.
Step, perform hand hygiene and put gloves or PPE if indicated. Sir, po, if indicated, sinasabi dito. So, yung PPE, huwag ka ng bed bag and then mag-start ka ng bed bag. Yung gloves, meron kasi kami na ano na video, others, first, hindi pa sa perineal, they will not wear the gloves.
Sure, I also agree with that, no? It's better magliligo na walang gloves, but it depends on the situation. So, if you think na there's infections and everything, then it's okay. But ideally, by the book, you should wear gloves. By experience, it could be different. Okay.
Next, identify the patient, discuss procedure with the patient, and assess the patient's ability to assist in bathing process, as well as personal hygiene preferences.
So identifying the patient ensures that the right patient receives the intervention and helps prevent error. So discussion promote reassurance and provide knowledge about the procedure.
Pasok, identify the patient. You, right? Oh.
Ah, yung ano pa yan? Mrs. Johnson, Mrs. Kananihan. Mrs. Johnson, what is your date of birth?
Good afternoon. May I know your name?
I'm Nora Isa Villa.
Okay, may I know your date of birth?
I'm May 14, 1981.
Okay, may I see your ID band, please? Thank you. I am Maureen, and this is Manichu. We are your CND for today, and I will do the perform the bed bath.
Thank you. Thank you.
Then close curtains around bed and close the door to the room if possible. Adjust the room temperature if necessary.
Okay, for nasara na namin yung curtain.
Offer bedpan.
Where to
offer
bedpan? Offer patient bedpan.
No,
bed Mrs. Johnson, before we do the performing bedpan, do you want to urinate first before we do the bed performing bedpan?
Why, man? Now, why you have to ask first if you want to tumahi or hindi?
For urinal, for male, we need to give the urinal and the bedpan. For the female patient, we need to give only the urinal.
Hindi na talaga isa na teamwork. Pagbigin mo kasi Jennifer.
Okay. Just ano na lang po, imagine na naka-gloves na kami. Nag-perform na kami ng hand hygiene. So, we will adjust. If CNA is on your side, so the bed rail should... Kailangan nakataas po yung bed rails dito sa...
And then for video purposes.
Kanyari nakataas po, lang hindi siya makapol. Then ito po ay yung sa side namin ang pababa.
And also things to consider, we should start the bed performing on the farthest side before the near one, so that you don't have to cross contaminate with your uniform or your apron. So you start with the far side, then the other side, the far side. Then also start from the cleanest to dirtiest, and from ano yun, nawala ako. From distal to proximal, fingers to axillary.
When you say distal, that's far. Proximal is near.
Ayan.
Ito yung
stop shift.
Bed blanket.
Imagine this is bed blanket.
Bath blanket.
Bath blanket.
Or dignity blanket.
Blanket. And then we need to remove the
top sheet that is currently used from by the patient. Mrs. Johnson, hold the.
Hold it. The blanket, we can reuse it because it's thick and then it's cold, so... Okay, next. So that is number 10. Number 11, remove the patient's gown. How do you remove the gown?
First, nakatay lang naman yung mga gown.
Okay, untie the gown sa likod. Okay. What if the patient has an IV on the right hand? Basa,
Marichu. Remove patient's gown and keep butt blanket in place. If patient has an IV line and is not wearing a gown with snap sleeves, remove gown from other arm first. Lower the IV container and pass gown over the tubing and the container.
Or four.
So, if po yung IV na nandito sa side, so dun muna
sa right na IV niya.
Dito yung word.
Yan ang right. After removing from left hand, and then
pass over. Basta kahit ano, which one will you remove first? The with IV or without IV?
Without IV.
Last time,
with IV.
Okay, that's number 11. Number 12.
Raise side rails or fill basin with a sufficient amount of comfortably warm water. Add the skin cleanser if appropriate according to the doctor's direction. Change as necessary throughout the bath. Lower side rail.
Okay, class, we have water, we have the gloves, we have the towel. So which area will be sparked first?
Face.
The face. Okay, put the towel on the head or the face.
Others are there putting towel on
them. Yes.
So, yeah.
Yes, to protect your pillows and your blankets.
Okay.
So on your notes, can you please write wash, rinse, and dry? Always, every time, wash, rinse, and dry. Okay? Next is the number 15, ice.
Ice.
Ice. For
example, this is the
ice mushroom.
Wash, rinse, dry.
Imagine nyo lang na check na ni patient yung ng water temperature. Tapos first, ito yung basin na may water and soap na agad. Ay! Pag sa face care pala, di ba, bawal yung...
Wash.
Pero pag adult...
Yes, number 15, basa.
Sabi ko na, 15, basa, with no cleanser on the washcloth, wipe one eye from the inner part of the eye near the nose to the outer part. Rinse or turn the cloth before washing the other eye. So
why
start
no
the eyes.
Why no soap?
For
eye. Because soap is?
Soap is irritating to the eyes, so
okay.
Moving from the inner to the outer.
Out the inner to outer, give. No soap.
This is the washcloth. How to mittens?
Mittens, yes.
This one.
Start from the inner cantus going to outer cantus.
This one, you need to clip this and put this. So from since I am here, I will start from the
far
side. Okay, for the eyes, I will use the other side of towel first, like this. from the inner cantus.
Inner cantus going to outer
cantus.
Cantus.
And then from the other side, you need to use the other side of the...
Why?
To prevent cross-contamination.
Very good.
Okay, eyes, no soap, right? Inner cantus, outer cantus. Next space.
Ears.
Oh,
ears.
For the ears, from the,
from the outer.
Outer pinna.
Outer pinna, and then inner pinna.
Very short, from outer pinna.
Yes.
Yes, start from the outer.
No. Dirty, ano dirty? The outside.
The outside, outer.
So yung mga dirty pastas na ro, para magkaroon ko ng uhog si Michelle.
Inner pina.
From inner.
Are you gonna use cotton buds or towel?
No, towel.
Okay. As for the ENT, I told you this before, right?
Yes.
As for ENT, you should not enter anything smaller than your small fingers.
But pwede cotton buds, sir, na ano, yung i-discard lang diretso.
Okay.
What you did on the other side, you do
okay, that. Last, next.
Next.
And then next is nose. Use cotton Q-tips for nose.
Okay. Ano yung Q-tip? What's Q-tip?
Cotton buds.
Next.
Then next is the mouth. Ay, mouth din namin itatake kasi ito rin yung sa nose. Then face. Using washcloth.
So for the face, first this one is soap.
Yes.
So from the face, from the forehead, going to the cheeks, and then going to the neck. From here, going to the cheeks, and then like next. From the other side. Like this.
So, let's all be similar tayo. Dapat 30-30 technique yan, okay? From the forehead to the cheeks, from the cheeks to the back of the ears, and then to your jaw, to your neck, and then going down to the shoulder. Then 33 also, here, the back of the ears, to the jaw, and then to the neck, and then going down. 33 technique.
Sir, diba natapis na natin yung ears?
Actually, yung face yan, isang dapat wala ng mga iye, isang buong face na.
Ah, okay.
And then, we also have the A technique.
A?
Yung letter A.
Ganon,
then sa harap sa mukha. Next is yung Z technique. Letter Z. Oh, yun. Ay, yung pala ginawa mo. Ay, ginawa niya Z-technique. So either way, the importance is that we'll be able to cover the entire face, right? na hindi tayo pabalik-balik to prevent cross-contaminations. Then, why did you try?
Yes. Rinse na, ganun ulit ang procedure, and then pat-dry.
Wash, rinse, pat-dry. And dry.
Ah, ito pala yung pang-pat-dry, ma'am. Okay, done.
Next is a body, arm. Okay.
After the supposedly hair shampoo, but you will not be...
Marilyn is doing the bed hair shampoo.
Then let's do the FNH, arms and armpit. The other side, para makita sa video. Si yung kasama mo, tanyan mo, tanyan yung nurse dito. So wherever you go, your towel follows you.
Yes.
Wash, rinse, and dry. According to number 17, use firm stroke, wash hand, arm, and axilla, lifting the arms, blah, blah, blah. So we will use a long circular motion sa arms and then sa shoulder. Okay.
Hindi ba yung kalahati na, sir, from raise or palm, then go back to...
Number 17.
Expose patient their arm and place towel length twice under it using firm stroke.
Pataas, di ba sabi nila kanina, from distal to proximal.
Meron din kami kasama yung hand first.
Actually, yes, kasama talaga yung hand, but for the sake of your nail care, sabi ko ba yung nail care?
Yes.
Foot and nail care. So, your hair shampoo, and then you do your nail care already at this point. Okay, but we will skip that for his report. So, we'll continue with the forearm. Long circular motion. Long circular motion, okay?
Wash, rinse,
wash, rinse,
and
dry.
Wash, rinse,
and
then the last is axillary.
Okay. And then dry. Okay, next.
And then apply appropriate moisturizer.
Next.
And then next is place a folded towel on the bed next to the patient's hand and put basin on it. Soak the patient's hand.
So we don't do that anymore because sa kanila.
Ah, okay.
Next. Like na, chest and breast na tayo.
Chest
and breast. Then half last na tayo. Then spread the towel across the chest.
Okay.
Okay.
So
spread the towel across patient's chest. Lower butt blanket to the patient. Lower natin so para. Keeping the butt blanket and towel in place avoids exposure and chilling. The next
one,
from the chest, if it's female,
bust under
you need to lift up the breast and then
skin fold areas.
We have to, you know, check the skin folds. Why?
Because
skin fold areas may be sources of odor and skin breakdown if not clean and dried properly.
How do you also lift the breast?
Using your
Yeah. Okay. Bakit hindi ganito? Pag-banyak ganito, pag-nurse ganyan. Okay, very good. Okay? How do you clean the breast? Parang ano lang, yung lang na ganyan. Okay? Then we're done with the breast and the chest. Make sure to pay attention to the folds. Same concept that you will use with the abdomen, right?
Yes.
Pay attention to the folds also. And then wash, rinse, and dry. Why is it important that you dry?
Because
Parang hindi ginawa.
Bacteria loves to stay in where?
Wet.
Wet